यूनिट 3 रियल वर्ल्ड इंटरफेसिंग विद आर्म 7 बेस्ट माइक्रो कंट्रोलर पार्ट 6। सो फर्स्ट इज इंट्रोडक्शन। द सिंपलेस्ट वे टू कम्युनिकेट बिटवीन अ कंप्यूटर एंड अ माइक्रो कंट्रोलर इज थ्रू यूआरट। नाउ यूआरट मीन्स यूनिवर्सल असिंक्रोनस रिसीवर ट्रांसमीटर। इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ सीरियल कम्युनिकेशन प्रोटोकॉल एंड इट यूजेस ओनली two wires for transferring the data. Normally we need to connect the microcontroller to the computer using COM port, but the modern day computers and laptops doesn't include a COM port as the USB ports have been replaced them. Hence nowadays the interface between a microcontroller and the computer is through the USB port with the help of USB to RS232 module that are based on the USB to UART bridge ICs like CP210X from Silicon Lab or FT232R from FTDI. So UART, that is Universal Asynchronous Receiver or Transmitter, is one of the earliest mode of communication applied to a computer somewhere in 1960s. The information is transmitted one binary bit at a time. As such, it is serial communication method. These bits are grounded, grouped together in the form of frames, that is a set of format for conveying one meaningful piece of data, for example, character byte. The UART is asynchronous because it doesn't require a transmitter provided clock to synchronize the transmission and receipt of data. So here the diagram shows that the serial data transfer in UART, that is transmitter to receiver, it is 0 1 1 0 1 0 1 0. So this is serial data transfer. So the UART, that is universal asynchronous receiver transmitter, is a serial communication protocol in which data is transferred serially bit by bit at a time. Asynchronous serial communication is widely used for byte oriented transmission. In asynchronous serial communication, a byte of data is transferred at a time. The UART serial communication protocol uses a defined frame structure for their data byte. The frame structure in asynchronous communication consists of start bit, data bit packet, and stop bit. So the UART protocol uses only two wires or the pins in a device like microcontroller to transmit the data. In that, one is for transmitting the data and the pin is called TX pin in the device, and the other pin is used to receive the data, which is called as RX pin. So for transmission TX pin is used, and for receive RX pin is used. As UART is a serial communication, the data is transmitted in a series of packets. Usually a packet consists of four parts: a start bit, the actual data, a parity bit, and stop bit. So the following image shows the typical structure of the data packet in UART. So zero is start bit, data bits 5 to 8, this is actual data, parity bit is P, then 1 1 is stop bits. So start bit means it is a bit with which indicates the serial communication has started, and it is always low. Then the data bit packet, the data bits can be a packet of 5 to 9 bits, we can say 5 to 8 bits. Normally we use the 8 bit data packet, which is always sent after the start bit, and the parity bit is P. Then the next is Stop bit. This usually is 1 or 2 bits in length. It is sent after data bits packet to indicate that the end of frame. The stop bit is always logic high. So it is 1, 1. Usually the asynchronous serial communication frame consists of a start bit, for that it is a 1 bit, followed by the data bits of 8 bit and then stop bit of 1 bit, which forms a 10 bit frame as shown. 10 bit frame. The frame can also consist of 2 stop bits instead of a single bit, and there can also be a parity bit after the stop bit, which is shown in this figure. Then the next is serial data transmission in UART. Just because there is no clock signal, a start bit is added, sent first to tell the receiver to listen out for the data. The receiver monitors for the logic high falling to the logic low. The receiver synchronizes its own bus clock to that make up the word being sent with bit 0, the least significant bit, that is LSB, being sent first. The bits are sent as pulses on the wire at specific time intervals set at both ends of the link to previously agreed values. The receiver looks at the voltage on the wire at these times. If it sees logic high, it records a binary digit 1 or 0 if the line is low. The receiver checks halfway between the start and the end of the pulse to ensure it does not misread the voltage on the line during the brief interval while the voltage is rising or falling. So this diagram shows the serial data transmission in UART, which has start bit logic 0. The start bit detecting transition from logic 1 to logic 0. Then incoming data sampled at the bit pulse center. So this is a word data from bits D0, D1, D2, D3, D7, D4, D5, D6 and D7. Next, P8 is the parity bit, which is optional. And then next is sample stop bit, that is stop bit logic 1. If two devices use a parity bit for error checking, that is calculated and sent next in synchronous with data that has been transmitted thus far. Finally, one stop bit is sent by the transmitter. The word length, parity availability, and type and the number of stop bits all have to be agreed in advance for successful communication, because UART uses 2 wires. The transmitter of a device A connected to a receiver of device B and receiver of device A connected to the transmitter of device B. This is how devices can send data simultaneously to each other, a mode of communication called full duplex. So this diagram shows it consists of 2 blocks. One is device A, second is device B. Serial device communication. So here transmission line, reception line and the grounded lines are connected in between the device A and device B. Now LPC, introduction to UART in LPC21485ARM7 microcontroller. As we all know that the UART is widely used serial communication protocol in embedded system based application. Almost all microcontrollers have built-in on-chip UART support. The LPC2148ARM7 core support 2 UART in it, UART 0 and UART 1. The UART 0 can be used as a general purpose UART and also can support the ISP programming through it, whereas the UART1 has additional modems support. Both have a built-in baud rate generator and 16-byte transmit and receive FIFOs. For UART0, the transmission pin is at P0.0 and receiver pin is at P0.1. Similarly, for UART1, transmission pin is P0.10 and receiver pin is at P0.9. So LPC2148 has two inbuilt UART, that is UART0, UART1. We can connect the two UART enabled devices with LPC2148 at a time. The UART0 and 1 are identical, other than the fact that the UART1 has a modem interface included. So we will see the features of UART0 in short. So features of UART0, first is it is a 16-byte receive and transmit FIFOs. Second is it built-in fractional baud rate generator with auto boarding capabilities. And third is software flow control through TXEN bit in transmit enable register. Next is the features of the UART1. It is a 16-byte receive and transmit FIFOs, built-in fractional baud rate generator with auto boarding capabilities, software and hardware flow control implementation possible, standard modem interface signals included with flow control, that is auto CTS and RTS, fully supported in hardware. Now the LPC2148 UART pins. So it consists of UART0, that is in UART0 it has two pins, TXD0 and RXD0. TXD0 is output pin, that is serial transmit data pin. RXD0 is input pin, serial receive data pin. Next in UART1, TXD1, that is output pin, serial transmit data pin. RXD1 is input pin, serial receive data pin. Next is RTS1 is output pin, request to send the signal pin. Active low signal indicates that the UART1 would like to transmit the data to the external modem. Next is CTS1 is input pin, it is used to clear to send the signal pin. Active low signal indicates if the signal modem is ready to accept the transmitted data via TXD1 from the UART1. Next is DSR1 is input pin, the data set ready signal pin. Active low signal indicates if the external modem is ready to establish a communication link with the UART1. Next is DTR1 output pin, the data terminal ready signal pin. The active low signal indicates that the UART1 is ready to establish a connection with external modem. Next is DCD1 pin, that is input pin, the data carrier detect signal pin. It is active low signal indicate if the external modem has established a communication link with the UART1 and data may be exchanged. Next is RI1 pin, which is input pin. RI1 means ring indicator signal pin. The active low signal indicates that a telephone ringing signal has been detected by the modem. Now we will see how to use a UART0. The UART1 can be used in similar way by using the corresponding registers for the UART1. Now UART0. Registers, we will see it afterwards. First we will see, coming to the UART in LPC2148, the LPC2148 series of MCU have two UART blocks called UART0 and UART1. Each UART block is associated with two pins, one for the transmission and other for the receiving. In UART0 block, the TXD0 that is transmit and RXD0 receive pins in the device are P0.0 and P0.1 respectively. In case of UART1, the TXD1 and RXD1 pins are P0.8 and P0.9 respectively. So for UART0, the transmission pin is P0.0. Receiver pin is P0.1, and in UART1 the transmission pin is P0.8 and receiver is P0.9, which is shown in this table. Next is, both the UART module are identical except the UART1 block has an additional full modem interface. This includes all the pins for RS-232 compatibility, like the flow control pins, CTS, RTS, etc. Both the UART blocks have 16-byte receive and transmit FIFO structure to hold the transmit and receive data. In order to control the data access and assembly, the UART blocks have two registers each. For the transmitter operation, the TX has two special register called transmit holding register, that is THR, and transmit shift register, that is TSR. In order to transmit the data, it is first sent to the THR and then moved to the TSR. For the receiver operation, the RX has two special registers called receiver buffer register and receive shift register, that is RSB. When data is received, it is first stored in the RSR and then moved to the RBR. Next is RS-232 level converter. Most of the microchips work on TTL or CMOS voltage level, which cannot be used to communicate over RS-232 protocol. In this case, voltage or the level converter is needed, which can convert TTL to RS-232 and RS-232 to TTL voltage level. The most commonly used RS-232 level converter is MAX 3232 chip. This chip include a charge pump which can generate RS-232 voltage level -10V to +10V from 5V power supply. It also include two receiver and two transmitter and is capable of full duplex UART communication. The RS-232 communication enables point-to-point data transfer, which often used in data acquisition application and for data transfer between microcontroller and PC. In example project, we will use RS-232 cable, that is USB to serial converter, to accomplish communication between LPC-2148 microcontroller and PC. But here make sure to install appropriate drivers before you make use of it. Next is register description in UART in LPC-2148 ARM7. So before we use any pin from LPC-2148 for serial communication, we have to configure and initialize UART0 peripheral by setting register bits. Let's quickly revise the function of UR0 registers which will be used in our code later on. It is recommended to keep user manual open to collect more details about each register if in case needed. So first is So first is U0THR, that is UR0, that is transmit holding register. Now this register contains 8-bit write data which can be transmitted through UR0. This is write only register. Here data to be transmitted is returned to this register. It contains newest received byte in the transmit FIFO, that is first in first out. The divisor latch access bit, that is DLAC in U0LCR, must be 0 in order to access the U0THR, that is DLAC 0. The transmit holding register consists of the top byte of the TX4, that is the oldest data. The bit 0, that is LSB, is the first data to be transmitted. In order to access this register, the divisor latch access bit in the UR0 line control register must be made 0. Next is U0RBR, that is UR0 receive buffer register. It is also an 8-bit register which received the data from UR0. This data is nothing but topmost byte of RX-FIFO. When we use 5, 6 or 7 bit data, then remaining bits are padded with zeros by default. This is read-only register. If the character received is less than 8 bit, then the unused MSBs are padded with the zeros. It contains the oldest received data in the receive FIFO. This register contains the received data. The divisor latch access bit, that is DLAC in U0LCR, must be 0 in order to access the U0RBR. Next is U0LCR. That is line control register. Now the value or the setting in this register configure the UART0 block. As this is 8-bit register, there are several parameters configured through this register, such as word length, stop bit, parity enable, parity select, break control, divisor latch access bit. This register setting plays important role while initializing UART0 before using it. So it is a 8-bit read-write register. It determines the format of the data character that is to be transmitted or received. Now bit 0 and 1, it is word length select. So if it is 00, then 5-bit character length. If it is 01, then 6-bit character length. If the bit 01 is 10, 7-bit character length. And if it is 11, it is 8-bit character length. Next, bit 2 is, if bit 2 is 0, then it is 1 stop bits, and if it is 1, then there are 2 stop bits. If bit 3 is 0, then disable the parity generator generation and checking. If bit 3 is 1, then enable the parity generation and checking. For bit 5, 4, again there are 4 cases: 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. If it is 0, 0, then odd parity. If it is 0 1, even parity 1 0, forced one stick parity, and if it is 1 1, then forced zero stick parity. Then next is bit 6. It is a break control. If bit 6 is 0, then disable break transmission, and if bit 6 is 1, then enable break transmission. Then next is bit 7. If bit 7 is 0, then disable access to divisor latches, and if bit 7 is 1, then enable the access to divisor latches. Then the next is U0. DLL and U0 DLM, that is UART0 divisor latch register. The U0 DLL is the divisor latch LSB, and U0 DLM is divisor latch MSB. These are 8-bit read-write register. The UART0 divisor latch holds the value by which the PCLK, that is peripheral clock, will be divided. This value must be 1 by 16 times the desired baud rate. A 0x0000 value is treated like 0x001 value, as division by the 0 is not allowed. The divisor latch access bit in U0LCR must be 1 in order to access the UART0 divisor latches. Next is U0FDR, that is UART0 fractional divider register. It is a 32-bit read-write register. It decides the clock prescaler for baud rate generation. If fractional divider is active, that is DIVAL greater than 0 and DLM is 0, then DLL must be greater than 3. Then there are some more registers. U0IER, that is UART0 interrupt enable register. It is 32-bit read-write register. It is used to enable UART0 interrupt sources. DLAP should be 0. U0IIR, that is UART0 interrupt identification register. It is also 32-bit read-only register. It provides a status code that denotes the priority and source of pending interrupt. It must be read before exiting the interrupt service routine to clear the interrupt. Then U0LSR, that is UART0 line status register. This is 8-bit read-only register. It provides status information on UART0 RX and TX blocks. Then U0TER, that is UART0 transmit enable register. It is 8-bit read-write register. The U0TER enable the implementation of software flow control. When TXEN is 1, then UART0 transmitter will keep sending data as long as they are available. As soon as the TXEN becomes 0, the UART0 transmission will stop. Now the software implementing software handshaking can clear this bit when it receives an XOFF character DC3. The software can set this bit again when it receives an XON character. Next is calculate the baud rate for UART in LPC 2148 ARM7. Now the baud rate for UART in LPC2148 ARM7 microcontroller can be calculated by the given equation. That is, baud rate is equal to PCLK divided by 16 into 256 into U0 DLM in plus U0 DLL into 1 plus DIVADDVAL divided by MULVAL. Now, what is PCLK? It is peripheral clock frequency, which is in megahertz. U0 DLM and U0 DLL are the standard UART0 baud rate generator divider registers. MULVAL and DIVADDVAL, these registers are the fraction generator values. They must meet following condition, that is, MULVAL must be greater than 0, then DIV less than equal to 15, with MULVAL 0 treated as this value 1. Now next, let us look at real world example where we will send string from LPC 2148. This message will be received.